So we got back to the cabin the other day, unwinterized everything, went super smooth, couldn't be any happier. Nothing shifted over the winter, nothing really got affected negatively. There was no water in the house, which was super cool. And it doesn't look like the new foundation really moved. So super stoked about that. And the third floor addition is still fucking standing. So stoked. I can't wait to do the rest of it. This is the north side of the house. The south side of the house is going to have three of these, and that is going to be an art and tattoo parlor up there for me and my wife. So I dug this gigantic sloped Arctic entry. It's gonna be the new entrance into the house underneath the steps. Kind of like utilize the space. And on the other side of this wall is actually the sauna. And right there is the drain tube, because I'm gonna be taking cold showers in there. And it's gonna all drain out there. And I really do, I still need to redo this foundation wall. And I thought it was funny that while I was digging this, I found an old septic tank made out of a 55-gallon barrel. Man, these people did just about anything they could possibly do to get by. There's an elderberry bush right on top of it. Luckily, I haven't been eating from it. Ew. So I dug this massive trench around the house to replace these, the foundation walls, reframe all of this. And this is going to be a greenhouse. There's gonna be an entrance right there. There's gonna be some gray water infrastructure stuff right here, because on the other side of this wall is actually the bathroom. And then I have my my cistern from my well. And I'm actually gonna frame this greenhouse, and then I'm gonna put another little greenhouse inside of the greenhouse, just to kind of trap the heat, and maybe put a little heater in here. And was debating whether or not I should put a compost toilet right next to it. So yeah, this is the greenhouse, and just a turn away, right here I dug this massive hole last year. In fact, I think I'm gonna even dig it a little bigger, just because the frost really did collapse the sides in. And I think for a root cellar with the thickness of the walls, I think I might wanna just dig it wider. And I dug down maybe 9 feet, and there was water down there, so the water table is like pretty shallow here, so probably gonna have to raise it up and put a dome roof on it and cover it in earth. The one thing that did suck last year is I broke the power to my well line, and it no longer works directly from the house panel. So I've been using this extension cord right here. As you can see, it's super safe, and it's raining. Yep, and that's how we're gonna do it for right now, until I build a little wellhead awning, and then I'm gonna put a service mast, or I'm just gonna trench it deep, like 2 feet, I'll trench it 2 feet down with a some conduit or something. And yeah, that's my house. This is where the old Russian man lived. He came with the house. He was in his 70s, super old dude. And then right back here is where my parents' 40-foot yurt is gonna be built when I get a chance. This house was suffocated in trees. And it was rotting from not getting enough light. obviously, and it was built wrong, and everything about it was wrong, but I cleared out about 200 trees, started organizing it for wood chipping, firewood, log furniture, stuff like that, larger timbers for building with, and then just in between my parents' house and my house, I'm gonna put a deluxe sized outhouse. This is in fact the outhouse hole that the baby moose got caught in. We had to get her out. And this too was affected by the winter. And as you can see, or not see, you know, there's a nice big floating ledger on this because the rest of the walls fell down. Probably gonna dig this bigger just to make it not so scary to work in, because I'm not gonna be able to, you know, use shoring or anything. Inside this pit here wasn't just gonna be a normal outhouse. I was gonna make a log crib septic system, something that they use here in Alaska and have been using for a really long time. Sometimes there's sinkholes in Anchorage and they excavate it to fix them because it's a chronic issue, and they end up finding a log crib septic system in the city. So they've been doing it for as long as that. That's my sauna stove. I'm so excited. I wanna put it in my house. Whiskey.